budget constraints. Assuming that you know the basics about budget constraints, this is what a budget constraint looks like. With the equation P1x1 plus P2x2 equal to m, where m is the income. And you must be familiar with the intercept, which is m by P1, and the intercept of the y-axis, which is m by P2. The slope is minus P1 by P2. Now, using this concept, we'll try to develop many other kinds of crazy constraints, which don't look like the normal constraint. So let's move to rationing. Now what is rationing? Rationing is when the government fixes your quota of a good. Let's say we have food on the x-axis and the government fixes the amount of food that you can have, say x bar. And let's say this x bar is less than m by p1, what you would normally have. So if your budget constraint, let's say, given the prices and the income, the government comes in and says you can't have more of x bar units of food, which means the government chops off your budget constraint, which means that you can't go beyond x bar. So this means this portion of the budget line is no longer functional, with the end result that the final budget constraint you end up having is this. So I can remove this part. This is how your budget constraint looks like when you have rationing. Now let's look at the case of a tax. Let's say the government says that after x bar units of a good, there will be a tax which will be levied. Which means if your budget constraint is like this, the government says that after x bar units, this price ratio does not hold. This price ratio P1 by P2 does not hold. Which means after x bar, the good x becomes expensive. Now you know when a good becomes expensive, the budget line pivots inwards. Which means you cannot have maximum of this much amount of x, but somewhat less. Let's say this point. So your budget constraint pivots inwards from here, like this, with the end result that your final budget constraint looks like this. It's the normal budget constraint till x bar and this pivoted budget constraint after x bar. So this is how it looks like with a kink and x bar. Now let's look at a simple shift, a cash grant. Let's say you go to your relative's house and you get, well, a note of 500 rupees. So which is a cash grant. Now what does that do to your budget constraint? If your budget constraint is normally like this, with additional cash, because cash is liquid, you can have more of both the goods, x and y. Which means this is not the maximum amount of good x you can have, it is somewhat here. This is not the maximum amount of y, good y you can have, it will be somewhat here. So with the result that your budget constraint will shift parallelly outwards. So this is what the cash does. Now let's look at the case of food stamps. Let's say a given budget constraint is this. Let's use numbers here. Let's say we have food here and all other goods here. Other goods. Price of food is say rupees 2 and price of other goods is rupees 1. And your income is rupees 20. So your budget constraint is 2x plus y is equal to 20. Now the government says, okay, let's label these points. This point is 10. This point is 20. Okay. So now the government says that you will get first two units of food for free. You won't have to pay for it. So let's see what it does to the budget constraint. The first point is the same. When you buy no food, you have 20 rupees, you can buy 20 units of other goods. When you now buy 1 unit of food, which is for free, you have 20 rupees left, which you can spend on other goods, which means this point is going to be 1, 20. Similarly, when you buy the second amount of food, you still, because it's for free, you still have 20 rupees with you, which you can spend on the other goods. Which means this going to be 2 and 20. Now let's look at the third unit. The third unit, when you buy, the price of food is 2. You have rupees 20 minus 2, which means rupees 18. So the maximum amount of other goods you can buy is what? It is 18. Let's say this is 18. And here, 3, 18. Similarly, if you buy other units of the same good, you will have to reduce your consumption of other goods. Which means ultimately your budget constraint will end up looking like this. Notice that this is almost like the cash grant, with the exception that it's chopped off over here. This constraint is not extending all the way till the y-axis, because you cannot have more of other goods with the food stamps which the government has given to you, assuming that these stamps are not tradable. So your budget constraint is flat till the point you can buy the food with the food stamps. So there's a kink at this point, and after that your budget constraint is just a shift of the old budget constraint. So this is about food stamps. Now let's look at some other kind of situations. Let's say it's a deal now. You have food here and other goods here. And the price of food as we took is rupees 2. Now the shopkeeper says that if you buy 2 units of food, the price of food is 2. But if you buy any amount of food more than rupees 2, more than 2 units, the price of food that will be charged is just rupees 1. Which means, if this is your normal budget constraint, with this the point of 2 units, what the shopkeeper has done to your budget constraint is, it has pivoted it outwards. Because till here the price of food is 2, but after this point the price of food is 1, which is cheap. Which means your budget constraint pivots outwards. So it pivots from this point onwards, because you can have more food if you buy the third unit, the fourth unit, and so on. So your final budget constraint ends up looking like this. Now notice that this is the situation. Okay, let's see another situation now. Now the deal is somewhat different. You have price of food equal to rupees 2 and price of food after 2 units. After 2 units equals rupees 1. This case of volume discount we will show here. Now, I'll just tell you the difference between both of them. Okay, so here the deal is that the price of all, if you buy any unit after 2 units, then the price of all the units that you're buying will be rupees 1. Which means if this is your budget constraint, and after this point, your budget constraint, let's forget about this kink. What will be your budget constraint if the price of food is cheap? Your budget constraint will be somewhat like this. Now the deal says that if you buy any amount after 2 units, this price ratio will hold, the one that is cheaper, which means